Hey guys, welcome to my channel, and welcome to my channel if you are new. Hi, and no, this is not Alaska, this is Winnie. This is my little niece puppy. This is Justin Ty's puppy. And she is here with me snuggling in my room today for some crazy reason. I love her so much. Hopefully she's not gonna snore the whole time, but you guys clicked on this video because you wanted to know the top craziest, creepiest, strangest Scottish urban legends and myths, and we are going to go through them right now. So buckle up, sit down, get a nice cup of joe, cup of coffee, cup of tea, pour yourself a nice cup of wine, cup of anything, and let's get started. So the first one is the devil in the bins, and it's like a devil playing cards with the devil is what it's called. In the 17th century, the Bins house was the home of General Sir Tam Dalyell, also known as Bloody Tam, an important figure in the Scottish military. The general made bold claims that he played card games with the devil on many occasions. The story goes that Tam usually lost to his evil opponent, but on one occasion he was victorious. The devil was so angry that he threw a marble table at him, which crashed through the window and landed in the surgeon's pond outside. When the pond dried up years later, a marble table was indeed found. The cards, goblet, and spoon believed to be used in the game are displayed in the house as well as the restored marble table which stands in the Lay Hall. The House of Bins is now a property of the National Trust for Scotland and is open to visitors during the summer months. With the iconic Tower of Bins, walking routes, and over 200 acres of parkland to explore in the grounds, that'd be a pretty cool place to hang out. Hopefully her snoring isn't too much for you guys. Oh my god, why are you so loud, Winnie? Why are you so loud? You okay? I love her so much. Next is Abandoned Annie. Visitors of the Real Mary's King's Close attraction will make a journey back in time to the 17th century. Before they can go back up to the surface, however, they must first pass through Annie's room. In 1992, the Japanese psychic Eiko Gibbo visited the close and was struck by the spirit of a small, unhappy girl who said her name was Annie. According to Annie, her mother had abandoned her in the close when Annie began exhibiting symptoms of the plague. Eiko bought Annie a small doll to comfort her, and since then, hundreds of visitors have similarly left small toys in Annie's room in the hopes of easing the centuries-long loneliness of a little girl. Can you guys believe that? Look how many toys there are. Seriously, that's crazy. Haunted Road A75. A long stretch of road through Dumfries and Galloway, the A75 is thought to be one of the most haunted roads in Scotland, with frequent unusual occurrences and even the occasional UFO sightings. I just feel so bad because I have to film this and she's just being so loud. Maybe if I move her. I feel so bad moving her. Okay. Oh my god! Are you serious? Look at this. Winnie. So inconvenient for me. People have witnessed visions of screaming hags, parades of people crossing the road, horses and carriages, flickers of gruesome creatures, and possibly extraterrestrials. Some long distance lorry drivers avoid the road at all costs. Next is the big gray man. He is said to be 10 feet tall, which is already terrifying enough as it is. and his arms swing wildly when he's sighted. The gray man is not a creature of flesh and bone, but has been said to be a ghost, possibly. Regardless, all who claim to have had encounters with this creature were filled with dread. The earliest known account of an alleged sighting of the gray man dates to 1791 and comes from by a poet by the name of James Hogg. The poet is said to have been tending sheep on Ben MacDhu when he saw the creature, and there have been many sightings since, but nobody knows who he is or where he comes from. Next is the Kelpies. These shape-shifting demon horses are a great deal more sinister than their monument gives them credit. Legend goes that the Kelpie lures unsuspecting prey to the water's edge by emitting a cry that sounds remarkably similar to a woman's scream. As its target rushes to the shore, the Kelpie lunges and drags them to their watery grave. The only way to save yourself from the Kelpie is to assert your mastery over it by grabbing its reins and tear the bridle from its back. While appearing as a human, the Kelpie will still have its hooves. For this reason, the Kelpie is seen as a malefic entity. In Scotland, almost every lake has a story about a Kelpie. Probably the most well-known of these stories is the one about the Kelpie of Loch Ness. In the past, human sacrifices were made to appease the gods and spirits of the waters. In time, this practice led to the appearance of the belief in evil water horses. Kelpies are the most common water spirits in Scottish folklore, and they can live both in water as well as on land. They often appear in legends as strong and beautiful black horses which live in the deep pools of rivers and streams in Scotland. Kelpies are known for preying on the humans they encounter. Kind of reminds me of like that scene from Lord of the Rings where all of the like the horses are coming like with the wave of water. Next is the Bean Nye. The Bean Nye passes her time beside pools or streams. There she washes the blood from the clothes of those about to die. She's an omen of death, though the evil that follows upon the sight of her is no fault of hers. So seeing her might herald a death, but she doesn't cause it. Although the Bean Nye was often seen as an evil portent, she was not always a portent of one's own death, and if approached in the correct way, she would grant wishes. All you had to do was get in between her and the water. You would then be given the opportunity to ask for three wishes and three questions, but three questions would have to be given truthfully in return, in the form of a traditional exchange between humans and supernatural creatures. This is literally nothing new. You have to answer all the questions correctly or else. Next is the Blue Man on the Minch, which I think this is probably my favorite of all of them. It's so neat. Legend tells that the Minch is home to a clan of mythical blue men. Most of the time, the blue men of Minch swim the seas, but sometimes sleep in underwater caves. While the blue men slept, the weather could be fine and the seas calm. However, when awake, they could conjure up storms whenever they wanted. These creatures that are size and shape of humans are very strong and can be seen swimming and diving with pleasure when the seas are rough. Following the boats that are navigating the waters of the area, they can be friendly towards humans, but this can also depend upon their mood and if they're treated with respect. Like the seas, their mood can change quickly and they can cause ships to founder and their crew and passengers to perish. The blue men gather to attack a ship. It is said that they will shout to the captain of the boat, challenging and threatening in verse. They engage in a rhyming duel, reciting a poem to the master of the ship, demanding that the verse is completed. If the captain completes the rhyme successfully and achieves the last word, the ship may be spared. If the captain fails in that task, then the blue men will attempt to overturn the ship and capsize it. In this way, it has been said that some captains have escaped disaster on the seas by their sharpness of their wit and tongue, while these less fortunate are left to perish in the cold and raging waters of the Minch. The second last one on our list is Selkies.
Hello, guys. Hello.
She's like, leave me alone. I'm just trying to sleep here. The Selkies. Hopeless romantics, beware. The Selkie is an alluring shape-shifting creature which resembles a seal in the water but assumes human form on dry land. The graceful Selkie may look astonishingly beautiful, but they can leave you lovesick forever. Eternally lustful, a Selkie will capture the hearts of human beings and then disappear forever into the ocean, leaving behind a few broken hearts. Yes, it is thought that both male and female Selkies can elegantly emerge from the water as a beautiful person and have powerful seductive powers over humans. After finding love and spending years on land, Selkie folk will always crave a return to the sea. Other stories say that Selkies have a moral conscience and return to play with their children at the seashore and visit them regularly once they've gone back to the sea. Have you ever seen a seal bobbing its head above water? They may seem adorable, but think twice when you see them, especially in the waters off the coast of Orkney and Shetland. You might end up falling head over heels in love. Be careful. And last but not least is the Phantom Piper. This one is pretty spooky. The unmistakable blast of the bagpipes is a common sound in Scotland, particularly in their cities and at festivals and celebrations. But what happens when the piper himself vanishes into thin air? There are several stories of phantom pipers throughout Scottish history and folklore. A dark network of caves extends from the cove of Grenan to the cliffs of Clanyard Bay near Stranraer. Like I said, I hope I'm not butchering these, guys. I'm sorry if I am. Locals believe that fairies live in these caves, and no one dared to go inside and disturb them until one day. A piper boldly entered the cave. He played his pipes loudly, accompanied by his faithful brown dog. The music droned on for hours, slowly fading away until it couldn't be heard anymore. Suddenly, the dog ran out of the cave, terrified and howling, without any of his hair. The piper was never seen again. On summer nights, passing sailors have since heard the distant sounds of bagpipes coming from the mouth of the cave. Bum, bum, bum! Anyways, guys, that is it for Scotland. Thank you for watching. And just so you guys know, like, I am a little bit of Scottish. My grandmother is Scottish. My grandmother's mother, I believe, was born in Scotland. Could be wrong. But I do have Scottish in me, so that is a thing. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Please click that thumbs up button if you enjoyed, and click the subscribe button if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell because I do make videos every single week. And I am getting Alaska tomorrow. I'm so excited. Oh my god, I'm gonna be making so many videos about that. I'll see you in my next video, guys. Bye!